Achi noti svastvartham yachare sthapayati api svayam acharate yasmat acharyasteno kritita. Achi noti svastvartham svayam acharate sthapayati api svayam acharate yasmat acharyasteno kritita. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, there is nothing in this material world for which a pure Vaishnava can feel attraction. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, there is nothing in this material world for which a pure Vaishnava can feel attraction. Pure Vaishnava is rare, actually. Pure Vaishnava is so rare that you cannot imagine this point. Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur writing in different articles that you can run here and there, you can go here and there, search out. After long waiting, if your luck is very good, then you can meet with a pure Vaishnava. You can go here and there, search all city and village everywhere. But to get a pure Vaishnava is a question of luck. If you are lucky, then you can meet a Vaishnava. Even after meeting a pure Vaishnava, maybe you cannot understand that he is pure Vaishnava. Nobody can understand the attitude of Bhaktidas Babaji Maharaj, Gorkisar Babaji Maharaj, always speaking very hard. Come! So usually, common people, they are making mistake. They cannot understand. They think sweet behavior, sweet etiquette, you know, outside, external, they think he is Vaishnava. But he cannot understand properly. Many times I told this point, who is Vaishnava, who is not. This judgment, we cannot leave into the hand of some foolish. Who is Vaishnava, who is not. This judgment, we cannot, we cannot depend upon some foolish. They can pass judgment that he is Vaishnava, he is not. They cannot understand. Quite impossible. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking this way, after long time searching everywhere, if your luck is very good, then and only then you can meet a pure Vaishnava. Even after that you cannot understand. Maybe you cannot understand. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking this way, in the name of Vaishnava, if you are going to get the association of non-Vaishnava, at the same time just opposite. In the name of Vaishnava, you are going to get the association of non-Vaishnava. At the same time, when you meet pure Vaishnava, you cannot understand, you leave them. Both very dangerous. Actually, it is not possible to understand who is Vaishnava, who is not. It is not possible. Then what is the procedure? What is the procedure then? How we can understand? Actually, many times I told, Guru Vaishnava is self-effulgent, Bhagavan, Sri Krishna. I told many times, Guru Vaishnava can reserve the right of not being exposed to your sense organ. What you can do? You can fight? Supreme Lord and His personal associates, they are so clever. They can reserve the right of not being exposed to your sense organ. Because all your sense organ, material sense organ, your perception, your idea, your brain, your mind, everything, your body, everything material. Though you are trying to do bhajan, but still you will have to wait to attain that stage. Very big problem. Big problem. It's a big problem, you will have to wait. You will have to wait. So, who is Vaishnava, who is not, this judgment we cannot pass. Only as per authentic scripture, some symptoms are there. If you see this kind of symptom, be sure he is Vaishnava. So many things. First, Kanishta Adhikari, Madhyam Adhikari, Uttam Adhikari, so many discussion I like to discuss after. But very critical point. Because Bhagavan self-effulgent, if somebody like to see sun god by a torchlight, Prabhupada speaking this way, Prabhupada in Upadesh Upakhyan, there's nice stories Prabhupada represent, so that foolish people somehow they can understand, get some point. Anyway, they cannot understand, they are so foolish. Somehow they can understand. Somehow they can understand. So this way, Prabhupada speaking, if somebody speaking, I like to see sun god by a torchlight, it's not possible. Because when sun god appears in the sky, at the time of sunrise, you can see the sun god, and at the same time, you can see everything as it is. Otherwise, not possible. So, many times I told this point, logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. Absolute truth, Supreme Lord, mean, Bhagavat Tattva mean, total paraphernalia. Bhagavan, his name, fame, feature, all paraphernalia, dham, nam, everything in total. In total summation, that is called Bhagavat Tattva. Bhagavat Tattva doesn't mean Supreme Lord is different, devotee is different. You can cut and make difference, is not possible. That's why those devotees, they are the heart of Krishna. Guru Padma Srila Bhakti Pamat Purgeshima wrote one nice book, Heart of Krishna. Mean, you cannot separate. It's not possible for you to separate all devotees from Krishna, Bhagavat Tattva, from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Not possible. This way it is very typical point. Now Bhaktivinoda Thakur expressing anxiety and tension for us is aprakita tension, not material tension. You are feeling always material tension, but Bhaktivinoda Thakur always feeling tension for us, like father and mother feeling tension for children. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing is one article. Many articles, Pratishthasa Bharjan, Satsangir Pranali Vichar, so many articles. Who can translate? Today I just complete one book, that book. Brother Sahajya, are you Gauriya? All scientific, nobody can cut point. Today I complete, almost complete. Then I have to edit everything. Very dangerous. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is writing, you will have to read all the time. Follow. You can remember I told you many times. Bhaktivinoda Dara can never be extinct. Never. Bhaktivinoda Dara, nobody can stop Bhaktivinoda Dara. But point is that Bhaktivinoda Dara at present flowing like Phalgu Nadi, a river, Phalgu. If you, you know, some sand is there everywhere. If you sight, get it, some sign, dig, you can find some water inside. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur and his Dara, Bhaktivinoda Dara can never be extinct. But somehow you cannot see Bhaktivinoda Dara properly at present. Because in the name of Harikata Hari Bhajan, in the name of Harikata Hari Bhajan, those who are misguiding or common people, we common people so foolish, we common people so foolish, we want to be cheated by them, deprived by them, that's why you are cheated. It is whom to held responsible, who is responsible, whom to blame. We are responsible. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking, we are following Ekadasi, Janmashtami, Radhashtami, Baldev Abhirbhav Tithi, everything we are doing. Ekadasi, everything we are doing. Baman Dadeshi. We are also putting Tilak Mala, chanting Harinam also. Going to listen some Vaishnava. Also, we are going to other place to attend Harikatha. Then we are in confusion about that absolute truth. We have a big problem. Big problem. We cannot understand. We cannot take decision. What is what? Big problem. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, we are doing everything. We are following Ekadasi, chanting Harinam, sometime fasting, doing Dham Parikrama, everything we are doing. But we are doing Vaishnava Seva also. Of course, I don't know who is Vaishnava, who is not. I am foolish. But still, so I am not getting any result. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, why those who are doing some practice, why they are not getting any result, proper result? What can be the reason behind it? Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, they cannot understand because they are in confusion. I give one nice example, very nice example, that, you know, competitive examination for service or any competitive examination, there are 100 objective type question, 100 objective type questions are there, each question bearing one mark, each question bearing just one mark, you know. And if you make mistake, then you can get penalty, -1. And if you give answer rightly, then you can get number 1. Suppose you are appearing in a competitive examination and the examination is over. When the result comes, you find your result is 0. How? Then after scrutiny, you find, oh my God, I write 50% right answers and 50% wrong answer. 50% right answer, 50% wrong answer, 50 - 50, 0. And those who are, you know, child, they are playing card, you know, sometimes some snack is a Ludo, is called, and this way. So snack is there. If you are reaching 99, if you meet with the face of snack, then come down, tell. You are putting so much effort, But after that, you are coming to zero result. This way, actually, we are foolish. We are doing everything, but we cannot understand properly. And at the same time, we are doing aparadh unto the lotus feet of Bhakti Devi. How we are doing aparadh, we cannot understand. Because our mind is very unstable. Sometimes we are doing aparadh unto the lotus feet of Mahaprasad. Sometimes we are doing aparadh unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. Harikatha, Harinam, Dham, all the time. When we are doing aparadh, where? We cannot detect. So those who are doing Harivajan, actual Harivajan, they are very clever. Yeah, so clever, nobody can cheat them. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, the personal associate of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. But when Bhaktivinoda Thakur was there in Puri, you know, district magistrate, and Bhaktivinoda Thakur got the responsibility of maintenance of Jagannath temple. Oh. That time, some devotee is doing bhajan. He misunderstood Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He cannot see Tulsi Mala inside cloth. Tilak sometime without Tilak. That devotee, Sarupdas Baba, maybe, I forget his name. Maybe Sarupdas Baba. He misunderstand and passing some dirty remarks about Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Then all of a sudden fall down. He cannot do bhajan, nothing. Then by the mercy of Jagannath, he could get clue that I have done mistake unto the lotus feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Then approaching and begging for pardon, please excuse me. I couldn't understand you. That's why I thought you are not Vaishnava. But after that I came to know that you are pure Vaishnava. Nobody can understand your activities, anything. Who is Vaishnava, who is not? In one line we can say one point. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking, he who is always busy to do some seva of Dham, Nam, Vaishnava, all the time busy to do something for Dham, Nam, Parikar, Vaishishta, everything. All the time busy, engagement. You cannot get even 1 second gapping. If in your bhajan, Mayadavi can find 1 second gapping, from there Mayadavi can enter into your heart and kick you. You cannot understand. So pure Vaishnava, you cannot find any gapping in their bhajan. Pure Vaishnava always do continuous bhajan, non-stop bhajan. Even sleeping, eating, everything, taking bath, everything. Oh, bhajan. Now there is a big point. Everybody doing tilak, everybody chanting Harinam, everybody is, hearing Harikatha, doing Ekadasi, this. How we can detect he is demon or Vaishnava? How to detect? Then Prabhupada speaking, if you find he is in the guise of Vaishnava days, but he is always against pure Vaishnava. When pure Guru Vaishnava doing something, their activities can never be wrong activities. Guru Vaishnava can do wrong. Is possible? How possible? Brahma, Pramad, Vipralipsha, Karna, Patav, they are out of four kind of faults. Which those faults are usually find in bonded soul. Pure Vaishnava, they never can make any mistake. It's possible, not possible. So you see, Prabhupada giving scientific evidence. You watch him. If you find he is against pure Guru Vaishnava, his Siddhanta, his activities, always be careful. He is very sweet, speaking very sweetly, polite, gentle approach. But you see, he is always against pure Guru Vaishnava. Then be careful. He is not Vaishnava. Before hearing Harikatha from any source, it is a request of scripture, not my request. Or you can say the request of Prabhupada, or Jiva Goswami is also speaking. Before hearing Harikatha from any source, you must, you know, try to understand the authenticity of his, you know, of his authenticity. I told during Bhagavad discourse, you can remember, Jiva Goswami was speaking, Bhakta Sarag Nirag Dibido Parikirtita. Jiva Goswami is speaking, there are two kinds of speaker. One kind of speaker, he don't care about what kind of pratishtha you are going to give him. He don't care. He speak all the truth, all the time, very heavy way. He never care. Only he want to satisfy Supreme Lord by his Harikatha. If my Harikatha is to satisfy Supreme Lord, then it is Supreme Harikatha. If my Harikatha is to satisfy you, it is not at all Harikatha. Come on, public. If I want to satisfy all common public people, then it is not Harikatha. So you see, Prabhupada speaking, that if he is against Guru Vaishnava, pure Guru Vaishnava, then be careful. Be careful. Against if Guru Vaishnava, then be careful. So, actually Prabhupada giving this Siddhanta, Prabhupada speaking in Bengali, Kantake upojukto jayga moto papte hobe in Bengali. You should take your ear in front of a pure Vaishnava, proper place. Because your ear following you, your body going here, you're going, your mind going. So Prabhupada speaking, you should put your ear in front of a pure Vaishnava. Right place, where actually fear, you know, firing Harikatha coming, then you can change your heart, dirty heart, because we cannot expect common man out of kama, krodha, it's not possible. They are always full of anartha. Common people, they are full of anartha. They are doing everything, but they cannot detect. Where they are making mistake, anything, they cannot. Where they are making mistake, they cannot understand. So, actually, today is the appearance day of a nice Vaishnava. His name is Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj. He is the number one disciple of Bhakti Deida Madhav Goswami Maharaj, about whom Gurudev Srila Madhav Goswami Maharaj used to say, Narottama Brahmachari is moral character, everything so high. His acharan is so perfect. Narottama Brahmachari, his Brahmachari number is Narottama Brahmachari. Narottama Brahmachari, his, you know, Vaishnava education, his, you know, acharan is so strong, nobody can understand. Actually, originally he is from Bankura district, one place. Abhirbhav and Tirobhav, all the same for Guru Vaishnava. Not that philosophically I am speaking, I am feeling this point. If you cannot feel this point, that Abhirbhav and Tirobhav are all the same, then what to do? You will have to directly feel. And one vital point, with anartha, you cannot start Hari Bhajan. Very vital point. Don't feel sorry for that. With anartha, nobody can start actual Hari Bhajan. What to speak about Raganuga Bhakti Rupanuga? If you can cut all Siddhanta in that book, then I can throw everything, all my dress, everything. If you can cut one Siddhanta there. But I cannot tolerate that you can become Sahajiya. I cannot tolerate, I can throw you out. I can speak in front of Supreme Lord for hours. Like in Suryaganda, I used to speak 8 hours in front of Supreme Lord, nobody there, in forest. In Gokul, nobody there. So I don't care. So you see, acharan is most important. First log I started with is from Vayu Puran, you see. Vayu Puran, I can discuss this point also. So Abhirbhav, Tirobhav, all the same. At the same time, I am bound to say, Tirobhav is more important than Abhirbhav. Why you speak this way? I can explain this point someday, when time is very limited. In Tirobhav, we can know everything about that Vaishnavi's activities, Siddhantas, everything. But in Abhirbhav, we cannot know. Many times I discussed this point, also I can discuss again. So, today is the Abhirbhav Tithi, appearance day of Guru Vaishnava. Today is the appearance day of Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj. So now actually is the Abhirbhav. Today is the Abhirbhav. He took birth in Bankura. I don't like to speak this way, that he took birth in Brahmin family is very bad. Vaishnava, about Vaishnava, I speak this way, then who is going to hear my Harikatha? If I myself making any mistake, Vaishnava, Brahman, Vaishnava, Kshatriya, Vaishnava, Vaishya, Vaishnava, Shudra is all wrong. We should not speak this way. It's not good. Big apparatus. You can remember one incident I told you long ago, maybe two years back. At the bank of Radhakunda, Prabhupada fasting for a long time. Why? Some Brajavasi Panda is Pandit passing this remark that Raghunath Das Goswami was, you know, Vaishya. We are Brahmans, so used to honor all our family members, I mean forefathers. He used to take blessings from them, because he is Vaishya. Then Prabhupada fasting, long time. Then all Guru Vaishnava, you know, whole society become agitated. All they come in, full troops. They are protesting against that Panda. Why you speak this way? You have to go and beg for pardon. After that he begged for pardon, and Prabhupada speaking Harikatha in front of that Panda, everybody, why I am fasting? Before hearing this point that Raghunath Das Goswami is not Brahman, he is Vaishya, I should die. Before hearing this point, that Raghunath Das Goswami is not Brahman, he is from a Vaishya family, so I should die. Why I am hearing this point? So I should die now. Because by chance this point coming. So after that, Prabhupada giving full judgment about Guru Vaishnava. Bhangshidas Babaji is from a fisherman family. We should not think this way. Spear Vaishnava. Krishna want to take dust particle from the lotus feet of Bhangshidas Babaji Maharaj, Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj. What to speak more about you and me? Why? In Bhagavad, I already told. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking in front of Uddhav. I am following Guru Vaishnava all the time. Why? Why you are following Guru Vaishnava all the time backside? Because when Guru Vaishnava running, somehow dust particle there with air coming and fall on me, my head, and on my body, infinity universe resting. So with this dust particle, I like to purify myself and purify. Also, you can remember, Sudama Vipra, when reaching, during Bhagavad discourse, I told you, Sudama Vipra reaching Dharaka, there Krishna washing his lotus feet and taking water on head. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu drinking the water wash of a Brahmin, pure Brahmin there in Gaya. All those points can give us evidence, 100% evidence, that Guru Vaishnava is non-different from Krishna and Supreme Lord. I mean, Krishna Chaitanya, not different. So we should not pass this kind of bad remarks, illegal remark, that Vaishnava is, you know, from a low caste, you know. You can also remember Jaru Thakur. He is from a very low caste, externally. And one relation, I mean uncle. Uncle of Raghunath Das Goswami, previous. A family relation, previously. He is going to Jaru Thakur's house. With a basket of mango, sweet mango, and offering and paying dandavar unto his lotus feet. And Jaru Thakur speaking, crying, what seva I can do, because I am from a low family, I cannot cook for you. If you give permission, I can give all rice, potato, potato that time not available actually. Potato only 60 years, 50 years coming in India. Potato. You cannot find any list of potato in the menu of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. In Chaitanya Bhagavad, Chaitanya, nowhere you can find. Nowhere. You know, even in Jagannath temple you cannot find potato. So you see, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you know, washing lotus feet there, where? In Puri. Jagannath, before entering Jagannath temple, you can remember that one spot is there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu never allow anybody to take even a drop of water wash. Leg. Water wash was lotus leg. But he, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu allowing three times. One, two, three. Not more. Stop now. That Jaru Thakur there in his house, somewhere in Bardhaman district, is speaking what to do. If you agree, then I can give everything, all raw materials there. In the house of Brahman, they can cook and you can take prasadam, then I can become happy. No, you don't become, you know, busy with prasadam, this, that, because I am already getting prasadam from you. Because you are pure Vaishnava. No, no, don't speak, I am not pure Vaishnava. I have come to take prasadam for you, from you. So that I am getting, you are speaking Harikatha, both of them discussing. So this is called actually kripa, prasad. Harikatha is actual prasad. After that, Kalidas, the uncle of Raghunath, going away. Because, you know, if I request, they cannot give their uchishta to me. Then he in a high, you know, is going to a very hidden place, very secretly waiting. And Joru Thakur getting some mango out of that box, basket and giving order to wife, wash I like to offer to Krishna directly. From here, mentally. Offer to Krishna. After that, taking mango nicely and all, you know, skin and your, you know, inside, you know, that seed, throwing into dustbin. And he's waiting. He's waiting there. Now after that, he coming and taking. From dustbin, taking the taste and crying. Today I am very happy. I am getting the uchishta Vaishnava. This way you can find Vaishnaver uchishta, Vaishnav padojal, bhakta-bhukta avasesh, I mean the prasadam remains of the prasadam, water was and food dust, but dust particle from there. Three are the medicine, very big medicine for your bhajan. For your bhajan is a big medicine. So be careful. Be careful all the time. Now they actually so about Vaishnava. I cannot pass this kind of remark that Joru Thakur is from a very low caste, this that I cannot pass. He is from any family, Haridas Thakur from any family. Caste and color, we are less interested. Haridas Thakur is unparalleled, unbeaten. Haridas Thakur is Haridas Thakur. Nobody can compare Haridas Thakur to anyone. He is Namacharya, topmost honor. Sanatana Goswami is speaking in front of Haridas Thakur, actually topmost honor given to you by Mahaprabhu. Topmost honor? Yes. You are Namacharya. Is topmost honor? Topmost honor is Namacharya. So, topmost honor given by Mahaprabhu to Haridas Thakur. Sanatana Goswami is speaking because Harinam is all. Harinam is the root cause of everything. Harinam is the root cause of everything. All your bhajan, smaran, kirtan, anything you do, any bhajan mode, Harinam is all. Even Jiva Goswami was speaking, if you do, if you are going to practice any kind of bhajan mode, 64 different kind of bhajan mode there in Rasamrita Sindhu, out of those nine points given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Bhagavatam Prahlad Maharaj, Sovanam, Kirtanam, etc. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving five only. If any point out of five, if you can practice properly, then you can get Krishna Bhakti, no doubt. Ei pancher alpo sango. If you can do, practice very purely. Any of these five bhajan mode, it can give you success. So, Harinam is the root cause of everything. Raganuga bhajan, Rupanuga bhajan, any bhajan. Root cause, oh Harinam. Harinam is the root cause of everything. And Haridas Thakur is Namacharya. Jiva Goswami was speaking, if you are practicing any kind of bhajan mode, maybe any kind of bhajan mode, Shravan, Kirtan, Vishnu Smaran, Padasava, any bhajan mode, But you will have to do together with Nam Bhajan. Jiva Goswami is giving instruction to everybody. Kalau Jadapi, though in Kali Yuga we have to practice different kind of bhajan mode, we know. But still, Sankirtan and Sankirtan Yogena Kriyeta. You will have to do through Sankirtan. Cooking, you are cooking, don't stop. Mentally, you must speak. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. All the time. You are washing your utensil, washing your plate. All the time, you have to speak Harinam. Sankirtan, together with Sankirtan, we have to do. In Kali Kal, be careful. Now point is that we are going to discuss some points, some speciality of Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj. What is the speciality with him? He is from a pure Brahmin family. I don't like to speak this way. He is from a, because anyway he is Vaishnava. If I speak this way, that he is from a Brahmin family, this, that, then I am going to insult him. I should not speak this way. He is Vaishnava. Anyway, so many restrictions, rules and regulations he used to follow in his previous home. Previous home, he used to rule so many rules and regulations, strict regulation. Common people cannot think about that. While taking prasadam, nobody can call him. If somebody unknowingly call, then he can stop. Suppose one, you know, just he started taking prasadam. If somebody calling, stop. You cannot understand. What do you mean? What do you mean? Be careful. This means this Vaishnava, from his, you know, in his previous home, he used to follow these rules and regulation. Harinam is equal to Hari. And pure Vaishnava is equal to, pure Vaishnava is name equal. Nobody can understand. If I speak purely, oh Bhakti Vinod Thakur, then Bhakti Vinod Thakur can present. Don't express any doubt in it. I give example many times. One devotee going to leave body there in Assam. He is doing all wrong activities. I told you many times. He was the disciple of Prabhupada, but not knowing, not following anything. He is totally, you know, mad. Doing all wrong activities. At the time of day, they find all Yamaduta coming to arrest him. All of them started calling, Prabhupada, save me. Then Prabhupada comes. Instant. Don't express doubt in it. Like mathematics. I just told you, Harinam is equal to Hari. I told you. Harinam is equal to Hari. Namas Chintamani Krishna Chaitanya Rasavigraha Purna Siddhya Nitya Mukta Abhinyatvat Nam Naminu. From Rasamisa Sindhu. Harinam, pure Harinam is just equal to Hari. I already told that those Guru Vaishnava, they are the heart of Krishna. The heart of Krishna is not separate from Krishna. Any limb of Krishna, finger, hand, eyes, ears, is complete Krishna. You cannot understand. Whole life you are doing bhajans, suppose. Still you cannot feel. By the mercy of a pure Guru Vaishnava, you can feel this point. If a finger trips of Krishna is equal to Krishna, purna, complete Krishna. Counterpart of Krishna is equal to Krishna. Because from Upanishad you should know this point. Purna shapurna madayo purna meva vasishvati. So be careful. So I wonder when Bharati Maharaj used to speak all this point in front of me, I say, how possible, come on, how possible for him to understand this rare points, to realize these points there. He is a pure Brahman, pure Vaishnava. Pure Brahman means pure Vaishnava. Pure Brahman means Vaishnava. By Brahman and not Vaishnava, it is quite impossible. Brahman but not Vaishnava is impossible. Smart Brahman, they are actually not Brahman. Without Krishna Bhakti, who is any Brahman, devoid of Krishna Bhakti, is not at all Brahman. His Brahmanism is satisfied by his Krishna Bhakti, Vishnu Bhakti. How we can say he is Vaishnava? He is Brahman. So Bharati Maharaj was Brahman, not Vaishnava, quite impossible. He was Vaishnava. Otherwise, this conception is very rare conception. Just now I told Harinam is equal to Hari, and those paraphernalia, they are together with Hari, they are the heart of Krishna. Many times, Ambarish Maharaj, they are also this point. Sadhunam Hidayam Majyam, I told you. So, this way you see, they are actually inseparable from Krishna. So, when I can speak, oh Prabhupada, from heart, Prabhupada is present. Transcendental. This Prabhupada, this name, if I can speak very purely, it is transcendental name. So when somebody calling, this conception is very right. If somebody calling the name of Narottama Brahmachari, by name he is calling, he is taking prasadam, then he is touching by harina, by name. Sound. So scientific point he used to speak in front of me and everybody. So how possible? Actually, he was supposed to take diksha from Srila Bhakti Vichar Jadavar Goswami Maharaj. He was supposed to take diksha from Srila Jadavar Goswami Maharaj. Because first he meet Jadavar Goswami Maharaj. He was impressed. But Srila Jadavar Goswami Maharaj was bhajan nishtha. Srila Jadavar Goswami used to do bhajan, very nice bhajan. He was the last disciple of Prabhupada, last disciple in the sense who got sannyas, last sannyas, not last diksha. Srila Jadavar Goswami Maharaj got sannyas from Prabhupada. He was the last, sannyas of Prabhupada. And Prabhupada used to give Radha Gayatri Radha Mantra to him specially. Almost rare. I never heard from Guru Bhargava, maybe somebody. But I heard Srila Jadavar Goswami Maharaj got Radha Gayatri Radha Mantra from Prabhupada, which Prabhupada used to take all the time. And that mantra I got somehow. How I got, I want to speak. I got. I have received that mantra, not God. That mantra is rare, which Prabhupada used to practice. Now, point is that Jadavar Goswami Maharaj were bhajan sil, used to do bhajan. And Srila Jadavar Goswami Maharaj used to stay in a very, not running here and there, most of the time, staying in bhajan guri, doing bhajan, doing kirtan nicely, speaking harikatha, okay. But Srila Madhav Goswami Maharaj, yeah, so smart, running here and there, So some point was there, that's why, after that he took decision to take this diksha from, actually, Srila Bhaktivedanta Mahadev Goswami. But first he took decision. All the same, no discrimination, we cannot make any discrimination. Maybe some point, I don't know. Vaishnava is all, you know, his thinking is also not material, whimsical like me. So this way he took the took Diksha from Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj, Bhakti Daito Madhav Goswami Maharaj. Actually, Srila Bharati Maharaj came late. Late means after Damodar Maharaj, Tujaswami Maharaj, Bhakti Vallabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, he came. A little after. But still so powerful. First batch of devotees, those who came in front of Srila Bhakti Madhav Goswami Maharaj, that time Srila Bhakti Madhav Goswami Maharaj was the Acharya of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You don't know the whole history. That time, Srila Bhakti Madhav Goswami Maharaj, not Madhav Goswami Maharaj, actually Hayagya Brahmachari, he was the Acharya of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That time some incident took place, some uncertain, you know. She was a maid Acharya. That time, first batch of some devotees came, like Srila Damodar Maharaj, Srila Tujaswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Vallabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj, they all came first. If you see the figure of Srila Bhakti Daito Madhav Goswami Maharaj, and again if you have the chance to watch the figure of Srila Narottama Brahmachari, you can, many people get confused. He is the son of Srila Bhakti Daito Madhav Goswami. People, they are in confusion. Sometimes they used to pass remark that Srila Bhakti Daito Madhav Goswami, he is the son of Prabhupada. But Prabhupada had no children, nothing. Naistik Brahmachari. From birth. Scientific Brahmacharya. From, you know, birth. How possible? But still people get in confusion. Maybe Madhav Goswami Maharaj is the, you know, son of Prabhupada. And if somebody watching the figure of Narottama Brahmacharya, so nice, stout figure. I have one picture. Young boy. So nice looking. Everybody, those who are not, you know, they have no information about this point, they used to speak that he is a son of actually Madhav Goswami Maharaj. So enthusiastic way of serving. We have never seen. My Guru Maharaj used to say, any Siddhanta by Srila Bhakti Gan Bharati Maharaj is scientific. His Vaishnava etiquette, his acharan is so perfect all the time. You know, so, you know, heavily. You cannot understand. Many times, Srila, I cannot forget Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj. Anytime, any writing I am writing, maybe some protest note, any books, I used to go to Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj, because last time Guru Maharaj was, my Guru Maharaj was so, you know, manifesting some little sick lila, so I cannot disturb Guru Maharaj. So I used to go to him, or Santa Goswami Maharaj sometime. They used to read. Okay, very nice. You publish, nobody can go against you. Nobody can fight with you. Used to speak, I am in Vyasasana speaking. I am in Vyasasana sitting this way. Any protest note, anything, reading. Very nice, you can publish. Nobody can do anything against you this way. No change of decision, nothing. Used to speak, nice. So I am feeling very happy. To remember, sweet remember. You know, my Guru Maharaj used to say, he is, you know, his seva was unparalleled, unbeaten. Two main seva, one is Srila Bhakti Vallabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, one is Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj. He used to do seva so enthusiastic way. You know, we cannot, you know, so nice seva. Any building construction, anything, main seva. Srila Bhakti Vidya Madhukur used to give responsibility to Narottama Mamuja. Any construction. I am very happy to speak very enthusiastic way. Any temple made, maybe 36 temple, I have to count, I forget. All temple made by Srila Bhakti Vidya Madhukur Sri Maharaj was done basically by the plan of Srila Narottama Brahmachari. He was number one engineer. Though no engineer certificate there with him, if you don't believe, you go to Calcutta Mutt and watch. So small Mutt, but so nice facility for all devotees. He keeping in mind that devotees can get old age, how they can maintain to stay there. All past and future used to sing, present. So clear vision, so intelligent, I cannot speak. It is quite impossible for me to discuss this point, how much intelligent he was. Super intelligent. Any problem happening, after Gurudev gone, everybody approaching Narottama Mamuji. This is a situation, what to do? He is waiting and thinking after that passing remark. My Guru Maharaj also used to say, any problem you all face in your life, after I go away, you can go and ask the Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj. But if you can go mad if you hear this point. One day I was discussing some point with Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj long ago. Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj in his room in Calcutta. Maharaj speaking and laughing, you think I have gone through so many books? No! Everybody thinking, I have gone through so many books, volumes of books. No! We got no chance to go through books. Only we used to hear from Guru Varga, that is my assets. Up to last point, we could feel what kind of assets the Maharaj having. Maharaj used to laugh. You think I have gone through volumes of book? No! Actually, everybody misunderstand. Actually, we got no chance. Always seva and seva all the time. Vaishnav seva, dam seva, nam seva, guru seva, all the time. No chance to go through books. But still, I get all Siddhanta Ratna, jewels, Siddhanta from Guru Varga. All their sweet association is my assets. So much patience with Srila Narottama Mamuchari. So much patience, I cannot speak. So much patience. One day, you see, long ago, not today, that time actually, maybe Srila Bhakti Vidya Madhav Goswami Maharaj was there. Maybe, I cannot remember. Suddenly, Srila Jajavar Goswami Maharaj took decision to go there in Allahabad there, because there is actually, where? Because this big, you know, festival going on. What festival? Kumbh Mela, big festival. So, last time Jajavar Goswami Maharaj took decision, last time, no time actually, last time he took decision to go there. So when all Brahmachari got information, Srila Jayadeva Goswami Maharaj coming, that they are discussing among themselves. Actually, the last time, where we can allow Maharaj to stay? Here I am sleeping. Here that Brahmachari is sleeping. Here that Maharaj. Where we can allow Jayadeva Goswami Maharaj to sleep? Huh? He is speaking last time. Oh, last time he is speaking. No time or disturbance. Then Narottama Thakur hear this point. And coming in front of them. What problem? What problem? What happens? No, actually, Srila Jayadeva Goswami Maharaj is coming last moment and no place there to stay. Don't speak about this point. My place is there. My place is there. Where you can sleep? You need not play your head about that. My place is there. I can allow my Guru Varga, Jayadeva Goswami Maharaj are there. So nice, you know, elevated devotees, personal associate of Prabhupada. I am very lucky. I can give my place. Who are you to speak? Pass remark about that. Stop fighting. Then Jayadeva Goswami Maharaj came, give place. He is sleeping outside, in sand. What to speak more? What to speak more? Srila Bhakti Bhumat Puri Goswami Maharaj used to stay with Srila Bhakti Madhava Goswami Maharaj for 36 years approximately, you know. Because Guru Maharaj never wanted to make any temple, nothing, no disciple. Never. He's so niskinchan. Somehow Guru Maharaj used to lead his life. But last moment actually, a king of Bardhaman, Rai Bahadur, maybe, he giving some temple, Anantabhasadev temple to Guru Maharaj. In the year of 1956, I think so. If I am not making any mistake, if I can remember, then in the year of 1956. That time, that king, Bardhaman, Raja, king of Bardhaman, giving one temple to Guru Maharaj, that was the first temple of my Guru Maharaj. Last, you know, first, you know, temple of my Guru Maharaj, Ananta Vasudev. When temple was first, you know, taken, first, there are snacks and everything, big, big snacks. And those who are taking wine, drunka, they used to come there in the night time, playing card, playing jua, you know, card with money. Used to drink. When they got information that one sadhu already going to Bardhaman Raja going to hand over this temple to a nice devotee, they become very angry. They wanted to fight with Guru Maharaj. Guru Maharaj is so humble. Guru Maharaj can never fight with people. Then actually, those, you know, drunka, they took decision to break the deity there, Ananta Vasudev deity, and throw into Ganga. They enter into temple with, Then enter into temple, they wanted to break hammer with some instrument. Then, from backside one big snack, standing. They all throw their instrument and run out. Ananta Vasudev protecting himself. Oh, run away. Big snack. Backside the Ananta Vasudev temple. Deity. After that temple was cleaned perfectly. And Guru Maharaj, no place to stay. No place. Only this small temple inside Garba Mandir, they are actually deities. Just small veranda, if rain coming, storm coming, Guru Maharaj should sit this way, in rain. No place to go. No place. Is to sleep there, night time, day time, every time. Oh, one, you know, small veranda. No place. Even night time, winter time, rainy season. No place. So nice Vaishnava. Then when first the temple was undertaken, that time there was a big function. Probably on Radhashtami day. I heard this point from Srinarathama in Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj. Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj speaking, Srila, your Guru Maharaj, Bhakti Pramod Purigasi Maharaj, and some Brahmachari, I also, going with Maharaj there in Anantavasudu temple, we find tomorrow is big function, but there is no article, nothing. No, nothing. Not even one utensil. One pot, nothing. I wonder how this, you know, Mahapurus, this great devotee can do function. Tomorrow, Radhashtami, today, actually we are coming, nothing there. No arrangement, nothing. He is speaking, Maharaj, nothing there, no arrangement. Guru Maharaj laughing. Krishna can do everything. Narottama, Prabhu, you can go to that house, they have nice, you know, utensil, big, you know, utensil, they can give in my name. You go and ask. Then going their house, their utensil there. For big function, we need big, you know, big, all the eight utensil, everything. After that, nothing there. From afternoon time, all sabji, everything coming. Like wind. Ananta Vasudev making arrangement like wind. Within 2-5 hours, all arrangement there, all full of heaps of potato, heaps of sabji, heaps of rice, wheat, ghee, oil, everything. Everything, Guru. Man, Narottama Mamujaya, I mean, Bharati Maharaj speaking, I gone mad? How possible? By evening time, everything complete. Madhavendra Paripad want to do big festival. Who is there to organize? Nobody there. Krishna himself doing. Annakut, Madhavendra Paripad, only coping is there. No cloth even. Even cloth is not there, only coping. So how possible to arrange this big function? So Gopal himself arranging all. So for pure Vaishnava, Krishna taking whole responsibility. For pure Vaishnava, Krishna taking whole responsibility to organize anything. We have 100% be faith in that. 100% faith. So we never try to deposit any money in bank. We have no account. Anything we plan, Krishna approve. Though I am not Vaishnava, but still Krishna approve. We are to speak about Guru Maharaj and pure Vaishnava. Krishna watching everything, arranging everything. So now they are actually, by night time, everything complete. Our sabji amaniya, cutting sabji, everything done, and from morning time, Srila Narottama Brahmachari, that time Narottama Brahmachari, actually. Who is? Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj. He is speaking, me, I myself, and some Brahmachari. Two started cooking. Narottama Brahmachari, big health, big, stout figure. Cooking for 1,000, 2,000 people. Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj speaking this way, Maharaj, you cannot believe me. In my whole life, I never saw that kind of big function. Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj speaking personally to me, Maharaj, you cannot believe this point. In my whole life, I never saw this kind of big function to happen. So big arrangement, so many people taking prasadam, yet there is no deposit, nothing. In the history of Gauriya Vaishnava Samaj, a spectacular thing. Like in Gauriya Vaishnava society, Narottama Thakur making one big function, arranging there in Keturi, at present in Bangladesh. Na bhutam na bhavishyati, never in future, and not in past, not in future, never this kind of function can happen. And second, Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj, as per Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj, Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj speaking, never in my life I saw this kind of big function to happen without any penny. Big function. Thousands of people coming, taking prasadam. So they are dancing, so palatable, so tasteful prasadam. He called, who cooking? Who cooking? Narottama Mochari. Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj. Maharaj speaking, when first batch Vaishnava, all big, big Vaishnava, who is arranging function, big function? Srila Bhakti Pumaturuja. Well, we can go. All big, big Vaishnava, they are coming to attend the function because this function is organized by Krishna himself. Apparently by Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj. Maharaj speaking, Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj speaking, first batch started taking prasadam. Jajabhar Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Kumar Mohsen Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Raja Madhav Goswami Maharaj, everybody. Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, Maharaj speaking, before starting prasad bhajan, that kind of jaykar, joy, we never heard. Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj, I never in my whole life, I never heard this kind of jaykara. Long jaykara in kirtan. After that, they started taking prasadam. So unique, marvelous. I cannot explain this point. So, you know, and Narottama Brahmachari, Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj speaking, I never feel tired. After doing so much seva, I never feel tired. Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj speaking, when I am doing Guru Seva, Vaishnava Seva, I never feel tired. In whole life, in my whole life, Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj speaking, in my whole life, whenever I got any Vaishnava Seva, I am very enthusiastic, I am very ready, I can do this Seva. This way. All took responsibility. To be frank, all important Seva, most of those, done by Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj and Bhakti Valati Togashi Maharaj. Oh, nice Seva. And he got, you know, Harinam, Diksha, Brahmachari Bes, Sannyas, all from Bhakti Vigyan Madhavasi. I am also lucky, I got everything, Harinam, Diksha, Siksha, Bes, everything, Brahmachari, everything from one. Lucky. This way, actually, at the same time, maintaining purity. Nowadays, nobody can think about this kind of purity. Maharaj fasting for 2 days. And here, special ordered from police department, some problem happening. 144, one law. When this kind of, you know, when this law is effective, 144 is one legal dara, some point. On some special ground, a police department is bound to you know, bound to arrange for 144. If 144 dhara is effective, then nobody can gossip. No two people can stay together. If police say, police can fire. Some special point, due to some vulnerable situation, some violence took place between that time. For this special order by police department, that time Maharaj running, coming and find he has 144. Going straight to the police department and speaking. You arrange my eye, for 2 days I am fasting. You have to arrange so that I can cook. Police department bound to give new pots. They must cook. And somehow with police court reaching Minnapur Mott. That time Minnapur Mott was common. Common means Bhakti Vedanta Madhu Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Vedanta Jajavar Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Guna Santo Goswami Maharaj, they all together, they make this mod. That time, common mod. After Prabhupada gone. During parikrama parting, Gaurmandal parikrama, in one place, Gurudev and all devotees, they are taking some light snack, prasadam. You know, some fruits, this, that. Narottama not taking anything. Then Madhu Goswami Maharaj asking, Narottama, why you are not taking anything? Actually, this, Gurudev, I cannot take because this, I heard from you, this is not proper place to take prasadam. I know. Then Gurudev singing this song in front of Narottama. Actually, they are teli. Teli means making oil. In their house, usually prohibited. Narottama Brahmachari is speaking, Gurudev, how I can take prasadam here? Then Gurudev singing this song. Sapacha grihete mangya khaibo pibo saraswati jal. This place is so unique, Narottama. Here, this kind of judgment you don't try to play. This kind of judgment is not effective here. It's Gaurdham. They are all devotees. Here, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, Sapacha grihe mangya, those who are low caste, very low caste, used to cook the flesh of dog, Sapacha. They used to cook and take. But now at present, you know, here actually Bhaktivinoda was speaking in song, actually Godroom, there is actually Navadip Dham, transcendental. Same point spoken by who? By Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj used to do bhajan there in Surya Kunda. Surya Kunda. Just in Surya Kunda I was doing bhajan, and just you can see the Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, Surya Kunda, that Kunda is there, this part Surya Narayan Mandir, just that part Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj used to do. Still today those Brajavasis, they put pressure on me, Baba, you come and take responsibility here. I say, if I take responsibility here, I cannot do Sarap Prabhupada. I can do only Haridam. Then in village. So there, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj used to do bhajan. Here is Sujanaran temple. Here is Sujukundo. Here is Bhangshi Das Babaji Maharaj. Here is actually Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. And another, you know, big devotee, his name is actually, I forget, in Surya Kunda, his name is I forget. I can remember. It's very Madhusudan Das Babaji Maharaj. who got Siddha Pranali from water, inside water. From Suryakunda, inside water, he got this in a stone written, Siddha Pranali, for him. Radharani giving himself. There is a spot of Radharani's crown. Radharani keeping crown on that stone is also there. Madhusudan Das Babaji Maharaj. So important, there I used to do bhajan there. Though I don't know what to, how to do bhajan, but by the mercy of Krishna, you know. So from there, at the last time, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj came here in Gaurdham. I already told this point long ago. Last time, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj came here in Gaurdham. He used to stay there in Suryakunda, there. Used to do bhajan there. Nice. One day, how and why Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj coming from that place there? Gaurkishore Babaji Maharaj also? Long time doing seva. There in Nandagram, here, there. After that coming here. Long time doing bhajan there. Why? One day, actually, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj going to a house of a sweeper. Sweeper, you know, low caste sweeper. Mathur. And asking for bread. All people saying, Baba gone mad? Baba coming here to bake for chapati here? How he can bake chapati here? It's not possible. Oh Baba, why you come here to bake chapati? Hey, stop! He is asking. Oh mother, Maya, give me chapati. Maya, mother, coming out. You are coming here in my house to get chapati? Is it possible for me to give you chapati? No, 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 you go. All village people can beat me. From me you cannot bake chapati, from our house. We are very low caste. Udaya Singh, one devotee used to cry in front of me. He used to do so many seva. He used to make garments for Sujanan. But village people never allow him to enter Sujanan temple. He is crying in front of me. After that, when I came in Govardhan, Dangati, he also searched me and find out my spot where I used to Dangati. Baba, they don't allow me to enter into temple because I am from low caste. But you speak Harikatha, there is no low caste, no high caste. But those people, the village people don't allow me. Still today, this strict, this kind of strict rules are there in Vrajadham. Now Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj is speaking, give me chapati. No, no, you go. No chapati there. I cannot give chapati to you. All village people, they can beat me. I have no chapati actually. Chapati finish. Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, see, I know four chapatis are there inside your pot. You go and open and find four chapatis there. Four chapatis there inside your room. How you know? You go and find four chapatis there. You get from me. Same thing happened. Vrajadham is very unique dham, you see. One Naga Baba, Siddha Mahatma. Naga, his name is Naga Baba. He is from Nimbarko family. Nimbarko, you know. One day he is reaching one house of Brajavasi. He is not speaking anything. No chapati, nothing. Only used to take milk, drink milk. Baba was so high class devotee, nobody can understand. Only one coping. Winter season, summer, you know, rain is all one chapati, one coping. One big turban there. Every day Baba used to watch Arati there in Vrindavan. Govindadev. That time Govindadev was not there in Jaipur there. 600 years back. 600, 700 years back. Baba used to watch Arati in Govinda Mandir, first Arati. After that, Baba used to do Harinam and walk and go to Govardhan. You think about where is Vrindavan city and where is Govardhan? Used to do Govardhan Parikrama, going to Barsana, Nandagram, after that going everywhere. In one day, used to do Harinam, everything, every day. And some special place there, Baba used to go and stand. No need of asking. They know Baba coming, means I'll have to give some milk to him. One day, one Mataji, old lady, Brajamaya, when Baba coming in front of him, her, I mean this Mataji making chapati in oven. Oven mean, you know, with cow dung cake, this, that. And is some wooden piece is there, is sitting on that wooden piece and making chapati. And that Mataji testing. That, you know, Naga Baba, how high class devotee is testing. Today no milk. You go. Today no milk. I cannot give milk to you, speaking this way. To Naga Baba. Naga Baba smiling. But Naga Baba never speaking anything. Only silent. Sometimes speaking. Silent. Today no milk is there, you can go away. I cannot give milk. Naga Baba straightway coming. The wooden structure on which Mata Brajamaya sitting, he displaced. And from one, you know, one hole was there. From there, milk he take and drink and go away. Because already know Mataji putting one pot of milk there for me inside that, you know, one hole, just to test Baba. Put one wooden piece. Today is no milk. It's coming. Wooden piece display and get that pot of milk, drink and go away. So now today actually Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj speaking. Hey! Four chapatis there. Getting chapati? Big fighting going on between the Brajavasis. They are speaking all rubbish against Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj become very angry. Hey! Baba, you have gone mad. You are taking chapati from Shudra, locust, sweeper. Huh? You are gay devotee. Babaji Maharaj become very angry. Hey! It is Brajadam. Where you find locust? High caste, low caste, where you find this Brajadam, a Prakita, foolish, I cannot stay here. You are fighting. That day Baba took decision to leave Brajadam and coming to Navadipdam. Coming in his Bhajan Kutir and speaking to Bihari, his Sevak, Bihari, I am not going to stay here anymore. They are fighting with caste and color. This is Brajadam. I can develop some aparad here. Better I can leave this place. I can go to Navadip. Navadip? How you can go? You are so old. You can take me on basket. Basket? It's long way, 2000 kilometers. So what? You can take me on basket? Basket? A long distance, how I can do? You can take me on basket, you can go. You can get keep up Krishna. Then putting Babaji Maharaj on basket, putting that basket on head, it is like, you know, like cotton. No weight is there. You see, nobody there here on my head. So, Nautama Brahmachari is speaking, I cannot take Gurudev, how I can take? You give order me to take? Yes, I give you order. Sapacha grihete mangya khaivo pivo saraswati. To clarify this point, I was bound to speak all these details. Otherwise, you cannot understand. Navadvipdham and Vrindavan are all unique. excellent, unparalleled, unbeaten. There is no question of any doubt. Oh, from then Maharaj started taking. Because Gurudev speaking, I cannot break. This way, if I go on discussing about Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj, his memory was so strong. Like my Guru Maharaj. Old age, 98 years, so strong memory. Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj, so strong memory. You know what to speak about that. Even in old age, 78, 80, 82, 84, speaking, you can remember everything. What happened in childhood age, everything speaks. Even in whole life, meeting one man, one time. Maybe in Jalandhar, maybe in Chandigarh, one time. Maharaj, can you remember me? Yes. This year, that time you came in Chandigarh Math. How you can remember? One time you meet you. Yes, I can remember. Any liberty coming, asking, Maharaj, can you remember? Yes. I saw you in Dehradun. That year, Hansan, you came to in front of me. How you can remember? So strong memory. Oh, scriptural analysis, everything. He used to speak on the basis of Vaishnava, on the basis of all Harikatha he heard from Guru Bhargava. That is our main assets. Ours is Sautopantha. Don't get in confusion. Don't get into confusion. Our pantha is Sautopantha. If you buy, you have money, you can go and buy so many volumes of books, you can memorize. But if I have the chance to hear from my Guru Bhargava, then I can come out successful. You cannot come out. Because I depend on Sautopantha. Sautopantha is more, you know. So, Mahajano Jeno Gato Sapanthya, I discussed this point also. Don't try to break rules. I can go on discussing this point. That how to organize your bhajan life very perfectly. Don't run here and there, you can die. I have no self-interest. You can go anywhere. I have no self-interest with you. But I am crying, you can die. I know what to do. This way, actually, today I am bound to stop my speech here. I am praying unto the lotus feet of Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj to get that kind of capacity, that kind of Siddhanta Gyan, that kind of Acharan, so that I can get up to the last moment of my life. Even after leaving this body, if I go somewhere, there also I can maintain. I beg for pardon from him. Vancha kalpadurvasya ke pasindu bhavisho patitanam pavane bhavishnan bhyo namo. One vital point I forget to discuss, that is that achinoti jo swastvartham, this point I can discuss next day. An effective acharya, how you can speak is effective acharya. How we can understand his effective acharya? Effective acharya doesn't mean that he can make thousands of disciples. Effective acharya means he can help you to accept all his siddhanta and acharya. Sthapetyopi. He can put some impression, stamp inside my heart. It's called successful acharya. I can discuss this point next day. If I get time, Purnimasi day, next coming, Purnima, Guru Purnima, I can discuss morning time.